about it. People disappear all the time.
Maybe so, but you took out a life insurance policy on both your wife and the auditor. Now the wife I get, but according to our records, you've never even met the auditor before.
So, he was old and out of shape. It didn't take a genius to see he was gonna die.
Funny, according to our records, the auditor was young and in good health.
Wasn't talking about
Ellie?
The auditor.
Are you here?
Nick?
Did you hear what happened up in Redwood 7 years ago?
Oh, God. It's really you.
Well, it's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
First thing I did was look up the addresses. And guess what? They're all from Redwood.
Happy to do it.
Yeah? Go diving into scary pre-war ruins all the time then, do you? Here, I know an amount wasn't on the table when you went out to find him, but you deserve a reward. Plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new partner.
Whoa. One case at a time, Ellie. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable. When you're trying to find someone who's gone missing, the devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how painful it might be.
My husband was murdered. He was just trying to keep them from taking Sean, and they just...
It's okay. You don't need to say anything more.
So, we're talking about a group of cold-hearted killers. But they waited until something went wrong to resort to violence. What else can you tell me?
We're looking for my baby, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? Why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders, super mutants, the Gunners. And of course, there's the Institute. Ellie? Are you here?
Nick? Oh, God. It's really you.
Well, it's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death.
Hey,
someday death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you. Well, you know how to keep a girl waiting.
Happy to do it.
Yeah? Go diving into... Here. You know...
Whoa. What? All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
Hey.
What can I do?
Go check that out.
I don't think I can get to that.
Check it out.
That's out of my reach.
Take a look.
Don't see a way for me to get there.
Over here.
What, am I supposed to wish my way over there?
Move here.
Of course.
Over there.
I don't think I can get to that. Yes. Is that one worth reading?
trying to find someone who's gone missing. The devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how painful it might be.
We were in a vault when it happened. Vault 111. It was some kind of cryo facility.
You were on ice, huh? More importantly, you were underground, sealed up. There's a lot of obstacles to get through just to take one person. What else can you tell me?
My husband was murdered. He was just trying to keep them from taking Sean, and they just...
It's okay. You don't need to say anything more.
So, we're talking about a group of cold-hearted killers. But they waited until something went wrong to resort to violence. Anything else you remember?
There was a man and a woman. They didn't say much, but I remember they called me the backup.
So we're talking a small team, professionals, the kind that know to keep their lips tight when they're on the job. Not sure what the backup means, though. Anything else you remember?
What's the harm in that? We're looking for my baby, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? And why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders, super mutants, the Gunners. And, of course, there's the Institute.
And it's not with a gun in their hand or a bomb in the sky. They're doing it with snacks, Johnny. Little Cookie's the problem.
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. A discarded prototype, anyway.
You're a prototype?
As far as I know. Never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal, and there's the newer ones that are almost human. I'm somewhere in between.
You don't know anything about them. Really?
Some kind of security setting strips or blocks out those memories. And it's not just me. Any synth that gets trashed, left behind, or escapes the Institute has the same problem. Probably some kind of failsafe.
Don't lie to me, Nick. You're one of them. They made you.
Yeah, I've heard it all before. You're a freak. You've got something to hide. Blah, blah, blah. But the truth is, people smart enough to build something like me are smart and arrogant enough to throw their unwanted...
Either way, I need to find Sean.
You're right. The speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
One of them came right up to me. Bald head, scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
No. They never said their names.
It's way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right? And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
Maybe it's another kidnapped kid.
Yeah, either that or he's got a son of his own. Not a comforting thought in any case. Both of them vanished a while ago. Haven't been heard or seen since. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
And now, an important public service announcement.
You've really gone through a lot, haven't you? Hope you and Nick find that monster. The Earl Sterling case. Apparently Earl just up and disappeared one day. No one's seen him since.
America.
A sort of
for many,
note?
It's more than just a country.
From a sponsor.
It's a heritage.
The Marty Bullfinch case. Marty was Nick's partner. Emphasis on the was. He must have been some kind of desperate to come to us for help after all this time.
Socialism is greater than at any point in history. Spreading a pall over our world, our country, and your dinner table. Why is it important to protect the American way of life? Well, for starters, the quality of living in democratic countries is twice the level of that in Europe, where socialism is rampant. Moreover, we have better food, better cars, and are miles ahead in the field of adult entertainment. That's because in Europe, the mile has been abandoned as a unit of measurement in favor of the more socialist-friendly metric system. We know this economic abundance is possible due to incentive. We know that with hard work, a good education, and a large trust fund, our children will have the opportunity to achieve all their hopes and dreams. This inspires them to put in more effort in the work, regardless of whether those goals are actually attainable.
Everything I dug up about Kellogg before his disappearance, bad news. He's more than just a mercenary. He's a professional, quick, clean, thorough. Has no enemies, because they're all dead. Except you. 9-1 odds says he's our man.
As well as a strong eagerness to check the mail. Either for his entitlement check or coded messages from his superiors.
Leading a small team to kidnap a baby and leaving one of the parents alive for later? Not many mercs in the Commonwealth can pull that off.
If you think someone you know is a communist, notify your local authorities immediately. A failure to act could be the difference between protecting America and damning it.
Nick.
Hold your horses.
Hey, Valentine.
Here we are. Keep an eye out, will you? See if I can get this open. Give me a sec. One heck of if it smokes a great big cigar. Let's take a look around. Kellogg must have left something behind. If it tells the biggest lies, where's the loudest eyes? It's a man. If it acts just like a cross patch. Place seems small to you. A guy like Kellogg would think big. Well, that's one way to hide a room. It's a man. If it walks, if it talks, if it happens, look at this. All of a Merc's favorite things. Tries to make you think it's wonderful. Be on the lookout. Don't let it fool you.
What if it makes the moon up on high? More than just Nick.
Check out what's on that table. If it kisses you and you find you like it to grab it. It's a man.